So, hello, welcome back. As promised, a really short video compared to the old one. Talking a little bit more about the 2236 V2 L-bracket for the A7 III and the A7 R III. And the A9 should work, except for the Dell part, which will work, but it's a little bit more difficult to get to if you use the top part. There was a few, I wouldn't say misconceptions, but a few of the questions people had, I want to answer. So let's first, if you just came here by accident, please also join our Facebook group. There's a Facebook group called Sony Full Frame Setup Tips. And we answer questions there about all kinds of topics, as long as it's related to the full frame cameras for Sony. And you'll find me there. I'm an admin there. So that's one thing that's just handy to do. So in the big review, one of the questions was, when can we get this L bracket and when can we buy it? Good news is, maybe I was not clear, but this is on sale at the moment. So I know yesterday I was also showing a prototype. But this is a full production version, and you can just go to the Small Rig website and order it. It's $99 for the complete set, so this part. So basically all three parts, that's kind of it. Then the second question was, but I only want to have the L part. Now, there is some bad news. They are not selling the parts separately. So you buy all the three different parts in one one set. I still think the price is okay, so you get also this part to turn it into the half cage, which I will show quickly again. But that's what it is. It's $99, which I think is still a great price for what you are getting, in my opinion. So you can order it directly from them or wait until your shop has it. The only problem that I see with your shop getting it is that you have to be quite careful because they didn't change the model number. It's still called the 2236. Make sure that you get a new one, because again you can clearly recognize them because of this tape stuff there, and maybe also because it has this small sort of, let me use the other camera, this small sort of hole that you can put your Peak Design plug or your strap in there, right, which is not on the other one. There's lots of other small changes, but these are the obvious ones which are easy to see. So let me remove the strap for a second. So yesterday we talked about that I would still make three changes. And I did first a review clean. I just wanted to point out why I made a change. They are not necessary, but you can see on my camera there are small changes anyway. So for example, you see from a company called Shutterstock that I always like to use these bigger buttons. So both on shutter bands, sorry. Shutterstock is a totally different company. So shutter bands, and they sell these buttons that you can put on your shutter, but also on the lenses. And I like them, especially on the A3. On the A4, it's a little bit less needed, although I still use the ones on my shutter. I also now use them on some of these buttons, and that is not, in my opinion, not needed on the R4 anymore. Same with this thing, there's a little piece of Velcro there, so that I can take this out and basically put it over there and put it back. There's a little bit of Velcro on the inside of the cold shoe protector so that you don't lose it. So there's a review also on my website. So now to the three changes that I've made. So yesterday I showed what I liked about it, but there were three small things I didn't like, which I talked about, but somehow didn't make it into production for all kinds of reasons. So the first one, and that's kind of a continuation where we started. So when we made the first one, like 3 years ago, we started out that we wanted something of this tape built in. And I found a brand called, it's called Gun Tape. It's called GT 5000. You can just order it online. And at Amazon, it's quite cheap. There's, I think it's like $9 for three of these chips, strips. And you can use it, if you use it sparingly, you can use at least for 5 or 6 of these L brackets. This is not needed anymore because now this is finally built in. But I also asked them to do it on the bottom, and they didn't do that. Now, yesterday I showed you the one without, and you can see that I added the gun tape on the bottom. It looks almost the same now as the others, but more important, when you're holding it, at least for me, and these are small details, I always like to adapt my things, but if I'm holding it in a normal way, my finger would be touching this area. And it's really nice that it feels the same in temperature. I know this sounds a bit weird, but it's in temperature as the other part, because otherwise you feel the metal, and depending on when you are outside or inside, what the temperature difference are, you feel that the one is metal and the other one is rubber. And I kind of like this. The second advantage is, if you put it down on a glass plate or something, it's a little bit less scratchy. Again, I will show it on the top camera also. You can see I just cut a little bit of this material. I got the shape pretty good, and I put it on the top of the door. Of course, if the door opens, you can see it still works fine. Now, somebody yesterday asked about also this part, and there was a misunderstanding that I think it was a she that she didn't get that you can still just open this flap, right? It's still a totally working battery thing, right? It still works, no problem. But I did put this tape also on there, because on the A7III and the A7R3, Sony still has this a cable feeder. Let me put it up. It's a cable feeder, and that was a one way that water would get in. So that's why I showed you yesterday that I won't take it off of my A7III, because you don't see it, or A7R3, because you don't see it anyway, and it does not interfere with a new construction. So that's pretty nice. And if you close it up, you can hear that it's quite literally clicks into place. There it went. And it's very sturdy. And you can also see that there's no, I wouldn't say this is a perfect seal, because I only can put it in water to prove it. But to me, I can't see any light coming through. So I doubt that much water will get in there. And if some drop of water will get in there, it still has a second barrier to cross. So I don't see that as an issue. So that's the first change I made. The second one you already saw on the bottom, which is a mixed success so far, because it's a little bit thicker. I actually used this M3 tape. You can get different ones. This was, I would just have this lying around. And it had to do not with a mistake that Smallwick made, but with something that Peak Design does. So I like to use the Peak Design travel tripod, and it has this sharp sort of pin here. And it was it fits perfectly into this hole, or perfectly it fits, but it would slowly be able to make a groove there, so destroy a little bit of the looks. So what I did, I put a little bit of rubber there. The second advantage is, because it's quite thick, is that it sort of snaps better into place. But it also, when you put it down, it sort of protects a little bit of your table or stuff in that way. I might put a little bit of thinner material there, but for a first test, this is not bad. Also on purpose, I made it a little bit too short. So probably the next one, I will do that all the way to this one. It looks a little bit nicer, but I figured this way you could quite easily see what I've done. I've sort of put it inside and then put it in this corner. So if the pin sort of goes in, it gets stuck here, and then it's in a correct position. So let me show you. I'm not sure how to actually do that. Probably, well, let me try it like this. This is the weirdest way to do it. Let's see if it's open, right? So it's open. And you notice that it snaps, hopefully, because I'm doing this now from below, quite easily. It's a little bit off center, but you see it snaps in quite easily. Did you see? And normally it would be much easier. Let me do it a second time so you can see. Once you know where it is, oh, hold on, I'm doing it on the wrong side. Oh. Trust me, this is really easy if you do it it snaps in, and then you lock it. And even now it's secure. I can, because it's in that pin. Now, of course, now it's coming to that rubber, so that makes it much more, it protects a little bit the material. And of course, now you lock it down, and it's totally 100% secure. In fact, this is one of the most secure sort of constructions I've seen so far for connecting a quick release system. I doubt it will ever be a problem. But I would advise to leave one of these pins on the Peak Design in. And also you can see you can open it up and it will just click out quite easy. So leave one of the pins, but it's sharp. So that's why I put a little bit of rubber there. Now the third change is even more silly. Because it has to do with, I did not like the small silver, and I have to turn it around, let me do it from the other camera. I did not like the small silver screws that we're using here to put on this part, so the extender part. So what I did, I took longer ones, which have these extensions so that you almost can do them by your hand. I can, in fact, if I really want to, turn them loose and fix them up again if I need to. But since that I'm shooting 90% without the cage, I will explain when I'm using the cage. I think this looks a little bit nicer, and the three screws are still there. Put the old screws or the supply screws in my little bag that I always have with me, with safety screws and all kinds of small Anand tools. So looks a little bit nicer in my opinion. Although if you are using it, I think it now kind of looks like a pretty sort of well-designed part. I know on the website, on the Small Rig website, because of they make the body gray and the device black, it almost looks like it's not color matching. I told them this, but they feel it's better to make everything that they don't sell you gray and make all the other parts black, which I kind of agree with, but I do think that it kind of miss the final look, if that makes sense, because you can see compared to the website how well this is now sort of matching the whole look and feel of the camera. And I doubt that anyone would ever notice that this is not part of the camera. Of course, many people won't notice that this is not part of the camera to begin with. And again, opening it up, press the button, and then sort of open it up. Now, I must admit that, I was pressing a camera button. So, but you can see you have to press it quite well this time. It clicks more than it did on the old one, but it should be fine. So the these are three changes. Let me just show you completely. Show the top part again, or the front part. So let me get a hood protector. Again, I would suggest that you watch the whole long video I made yesterday, or at least skim it, because this is more meant to show you the three changes that I've made. But you can now see from the top view how I replaced these three screws with these more, the ones that you can sort of put in by hand. They have this, I'm not sure what you call this, gnarly sort of edge to it. Of course, you take them out and then you can put this part on again, etc. Oh, it's the other way around. Yeah, it's the correct way around. Of course, I can't put it on fully now, but you kind of get the feeling how it works. Now, the last question I wanted to answer is it bad that they sell this part mandatory? I personally feel, and they have their reasons not to do this, I personally feel it would be nicer if they would sell this as an optional part, but they don't. So yeah, that's what it is. I do think that for me at least, it's already quite nice to have it with me, simply because when I'm traveling, I do put this part on, Because as you already can see, this top is quite is really higher than the camera itself. So once you put it in there, and I leave the lens on most time, I put it in my bag, but it's kind of much more secure in the bag because the top part is metal, the lower part is metal, and it snugly, for me at least, fits into my bag. So the top is also secured if the bag gets hit. Now, when I get to the location, I will take it off and I will just keep this in the bag. Of course, if you want to use it for video, then it makes perfect sense to use it. That seems like an obvious thing, right? And you can see what kind of ads, things you can add to it on the website. So yes, I understand that some people want to have this part without the front and top part, so not to turn it into a half case, but it's not going to happen, so at least not at this time. So then the last questions I got is, when will the versions be out for the A7 R4 and the A7 M4 most likely, and the A7 R4, A9 Mark II, and the S3 will be my guess, and the M4. I'm pretty sure the 3 without the S. Yeah, we are not sure. It's all about the flippy screen, right? So Smallwerk already makes a part where this part is different. So there's a hole here so that you can add the flippy screen, or you can open up the flippy screen. I hope that they will still sell a version soon for the A7 III and the M4, if that has this hole in there. And they just split the two versions, because the only thing that need to redesign is this part. And I'm pretty convinced that the S3 and the M4, and so the Sony A7 Mark IV and the Sony S3, so the new video camera, that they will in fact have the same grip, because they are using the same battery grip, which is a good hint. So that means that the bottom part is totally the same. So that means that this L bracket should fit. So if you see, for example, on the S3, they say that the width is 3 millimeters thicker. But if you really look at the drawings, you will find that it's in a little bit in the top part of the body. So basically in this part, which does not really affect the L bracket. And most of it is actually in the EVF. So they made the EVF stick out a little bit. That's also why I have this other cup on here, to make it stick out a little bit for my nose not touching the screen as much. And I think one of the changes that they made, which is kind of, I wouldn't say confusing, but giving people the feeling that the A7 S3 is a lot thicker, which I don't think it actually is because of the EVF sticking out a little bit more, if you look at the different drawings. So this is about the three changes. So you can just buy it now. If you do DHL, they will ship it to you in 3 or 4 days. I've ordered them many times. Of course, in this case, because I helped on the design, I didn't order it. They ship it, it to me. But that does not really matter, because normally, it does matter, but it's the same sort of shipping method. About 50% of the stuff that I buy there, I buy directly. Others I buy using my own local shops in the Netherlands. And I'm pretty sure at some point they will also start selling this one in the big local shops. I'm not sure when they will be on Amazon.com or Amazon.uk or Amazon.de. But the tricky part there is, in my view, if you really want it now, and the price will probably end up being kind of the same, I would order it at Smallwerk. And I would also, because that's the only way to make sure that you're getting the V2 version, because the number of the part is still called the Smallwerk 2236. So they didn't update the model number. So that's it. As promised, the three changes that I've made to, in my opinion now, the best L bracket for the A7 III and the A7 R3. And it's been quite a long travel. I think we had 3 or 4 different versions. But to me, this is, I love, except of course the small changes I made myself. I can't imagine a better solution, or something that could have been improved for me at least. So, yeah, thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.